If you love Southern Africa like I do, then you definitely have Zambia on your radar. This is an amazing and interesting and a robust economy on the northern side of where I come from, of Zimbabwe. Of course, you will realize that if you studied your history enough, you would actually know that Zambia, Zimbabwe and Malawi were once one country under a federation, with the capital being in Zimbabwe, in Harare. It is a dream, of course, that would have been actually much more amazing if Mozambique had been added and we'd had a federation with ocean access. Of course, this is not what happened, and I always try to figure out why we did not have this big agglomeration as a big African economy that would challenge the dominance of South Africa in the South. But definitely, who knows what the future has. But today, we're not going to talk about the past, we're not going to talk about the history, but we're going to talk about the future and what the future might hold if you choose to put some of your money and invest it in Zambia on the Lusaka Securities Exchange. This is what this video is about. This video is about how I opened my account to start investing on the Lusaka Securities Exchange, and for you to figure out whether this is an economy that you actually want to put some of your hard-earned money in on the African continent, and for you to figure out whether this is something where you think your returns will be very good in terms of the risks that you take in putting your money in that market. So now, why Zambia? Well, Zambia is actually an interesting country. Zambia is a very robust economy that has a lot of mineral resources under it. A lot of them being mined right now, but I predict a lot of them still under the ground and some even yet to be found. As you can see, something that constantly happens in many African countries where diamonds or chrome or anything just pops up and people discover how rich they are given the poverty they have been living in. In addition to the mining that is very robust in Zambia to speak as of now, there's also a very interesting and stable tourism industry that's growing. You realize, of course, that tourism is actually a good export earner for people who are coming in to relax. And Zambia has been very stable in terms of, you know, its security. It's been very stable in terms of welcoming tourists and people who have gone there. And I have visited Zambia myself. Some other people who have also gone there, if you think I'm biased, have testified that it's a great country to be in. Amazing people. I have Zambian friends. They are good people, and anyone who has interacted with Zambians or visited that country will tell you that it's generally a positive country to be in. There's a good vibe, and that the economy has been showing signs of growing. This is not just from the streets, but if you read any of these international reports, if you look at the World Bank, if you look at the African Development Bank, you see that there are some good predictions that are actually there for the Zambian economy. And so definitely this is something that would give you comfort if you're someone who is still in doubt about whether Zambia is the place for you to start investing part of your money in on the African continent. Now let's look at the numbers, shall we? The Lusaka Stock Exchange All Share Index, which is definitely something that agglomerates all the shares that are listed on the Lusaka Securities Exchange, in the past month alone, that index has gone up 1.86%. In the past 3 months, it has gone up 4.3%. And year to date, which is starting from the beginning of this year until today when I'm recording this video, Monday, May 31 at 1:06:10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time in the United States, that market has gone up year to date 6.21%. So this is something that's good. You won't have many countries where money is growing at 6.21%. Certainly not in most developed markets where, you know, interest rates are in the negatives and a lot of people are trying to cry their savings, trying to figure out where to put their money. This is something that you'll find money is actually growing. And of course, this is in US dollar terms. We're not actually talking of local currency here. So if you have decided, if you think these numbers are interesting, and if you think that this economy is something that's worth taking a look at, put just a little bit of your money, then I'm going to walk you through the journey of how you actually do it. How do you get to open an account to start investing on the Lusaka Securities Exchange? Now, firstly, I'm going to assume that you actually have no knowledge of the Lusaka Securities Exchange, of the companies that are listed there, and of the Zambian economy in general. And so one thing you certainly want to do is to start reading, researching, and understanding this market. A video will pop up there that will show you my sources of information on African stock markets. And then, of course, from that video, you can be able to tailor this and figure out sources of information for the Zambian stock market in general, and for you to understand and get sort of a historical background which will be necessary for you to study and understand the future of this market. So definitely you actually want to understand the market as a whole and to understand the companies and get a basic understanding of the economy. That way you can be able to focus on which sectors you want to invest in, and within those sectors you'll be able to figure out and narrow down which companies you would want to invest on the Lusaka Securities Exchange. Now, going on to the second point, you actually want to go to the website of the Lusaka Securities Exchange and to be able to choose your brokers. It's good here in this case for Zambia that they only have six brokers. Six, that's all. So you just have to send out six emails to six different brokers and wait and sit tight and see who replies. In my case, I think I had a 50% response rate. Three brokers replied. The other three, probably my email slipped through to their spam or something else. But three of the brokers replied. And after you email them and tell them who you are, that you want to invest in Zambia, and these are the sectors that you're interested in and that you want to look at, if you want to invest in their tourism companies, if you want to invest in their mining, if you want to invest in, you know, their consumer discretionary companies, you tell the brokers what you want. And definitely after you do that, then you get your response emails, and then you'll be able to narrow it down from there. The narrowing down is also something that's more of an art than an exact science. The art is in the fact that if all the brokers respond to you, if you're lucky that all the brokers respond to you, then you'll be faced with a choice where, you know, you could go through sort of the website test, which I do in some African countries, where you look at their websites, look at which brokers have better websites, and choose the brokers with good websites. But that might not be the best way to do it in this case. What you actually want to do is you want to look at the research they offer, ask them about past research that they have given out. Say, look guys, what research have you given out in the past? I want to read it and see whether how detailed it is and whether it can help me make decisions if you are assuming that the research has been given out today. And then of course, after that, you want to ask them if they offer broker controlled accounts. That is, if you're a very new investor who does not really have a lot of knowledge, but you want to start right away, you might want to just send your money to your broker and make the broker take the decision of what to buy. You want to ask them if they do this, if this is something that you are really considering. And then you also want to ask them if they require you to open a local bank account for you to invest in their market. That is, for you to receive your sale proceeds and for you to receive your dividend proceeds, because local bank accounts are much more difficult to open than actually just opening a stockbroking account. So definitely you want to ask them and you want to know this information beforehand, before you commit to opening an account with their stockbroking firm. Now let's get on to the requirements. The requirements in terms of the broker that I use were very simple. They needed a proof of residence, wanted to know where you live, for know your client information, money laundering, and all these things. You guys can read up on that and understand why they need a proof of residence. Of course, they wanted their account opening form filled out, you know, signed and scanned and sent to them. They wanted a notarized valid ID, in this case a passport, given I'm not a Zambian citizen myself. And they also wanted your source of income, you know, to prove where are you getting your money, because you don't want to be a money launderer who is just looking to clean your money using the Lusaka Securities Exchange. And then of course, lastly, they wanted, you know, a passport size photo, which you can just scan and send it to them. If they say three, it will just be the same thing, because you know, it's a passport size photo, so they will look alike. And then after that, definitely some viewers would want to know, is there a minimum amount for you to invest on the Lusaka Securities Exchange? The answer is yes. There is a minimum amount that you are required to put in when you put in an order on the Lusaka Securities Exchange. This minimum amount is 250 kwacha. Well, you know, you just say, hold on, stop there. Like, what is 250 kwacha? You have to go on Google and understand this. I will do that for you. As I checked it today, just about 30 minutes ago, before recording this video, this amount was equal to 11.11 US dollars. So whatever currency that you use in whatever country that you have, you just have to think that the equivalent of 11 US dollars, just say 12, the equivalent of 12 in case this rate does something, but Zambia has had actually a stable exchange rate for a long time. But the equivalent of 12 dollars is the minimum amount that you have to invest if you're putting in an order on the Lusaka Securities Exchange. So depending on, you know, your sources of funds, this is something that is pretty much reasonable. This is something that most people will find within their means and they can be able to invest in this market. how do I fund my account, given that, you know, I don't have a bank account in Zambia. What you have to do is that you have to do wire transfers. If you have a bank account in Zambia, then I'm guessing some of these things will be way, way much easier for you, and you even be able to tell us in the comments below how you do it, given you have a bank account in Zambia. But if you don't have a bank account in Zambia, then you're looking at making international wire transfers that you make from your bank in whatever country that you live in and send it to the bank of the stockbroker in Zambia, and then that can be done. For dividends, these can be sent to an international bank account. There is no problem with that. And so definitely, this is something that makes it easy, because local bank accounts, as I always say, are much more difficult to open compared to just opening a stockbroking account in a different African country. Last point. How do we communicate? Just like any other African broker, these guys have emails. You know, everything is seamless. You communicate with these guys over emails. If you have time zone differences, then maybe it might be slower, because then you would send these guys an email. They wake up, they respond to you while you are asleep and whatever. But if something comes up that's pretty urgent, you do the calls. You know, the guys are pretty much responsive in terms of their calls and their offices and everything else. Zambia is an English-speaking country, so if you're not English-speaking, then maybe you figure out ways to translate with that and everything, but the brokers pretty much will talk to you on the phone in English, and so that can be something that can be helpful if you're trying to figure out whether there's any language barrier there in terms of investing in Zambia. But this is just a broader perspective of how you go about to be able to get to the point where you actually now have an account that is fully functional and fully opened, and that is ready for you to start investing on the Lusaka Securities Exchange. If you have been investing in Lusaka, if you have had experiences of investing in Lusaka, or if you are looking towards to starting to investing in Lusaka, do let me know in the comments below, and we'll be able to interact and figure out how the investment story unfolds. And of course, a couple of years, 5, 10, 15 years from now, we'll look back and we'll all realize how it was the best decision of our life for us to start investing on African stock markets. And until next time, and until the next video, see you. My name is Maro.